Let's start.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome. Welcome to the webinar. We are in Jan 3rd of 2017. So this is actually quite an ideal time to just look at what's going on, where we are, you know, from various angles. And that's the problem with the markets, is that you have to look at it from various angles, you know, and especially this year. So because there's lots of stuff going on. You know, why are we, you know, why is 2017 in my mind, by the way, and this, okay, it doesn't, it's not corroborated by anybody. It's not been consulted, verified, nothing. Okay. Everybody's going to have an opinion. Even the professional analysts are going to have an opinion. But does that mean that they're going to be right? No, absolutely not. Nobody's going to be right. And that's, you know, really the beauty of the markets, is that not one person is going to be right. I mean, they might be right on one thing, but they'll be wrong on something else. Because, and that's why even technical analysis, see, it's a study of crowd behavior, right? And it becomes so important in situations like this, because everybody's looking at each other and wondering, okay, what's going to happen this year? Nobody wants to take the first move. So, but when somebody comes in, some big players come in and start putting in big money into something, the rest will follow. I mean, that's just crowd behavior. And technical analysis, basically, fundamental premise is that crowds behave in predictable matters, which is very true. There is a lot of opportunity, okay, in this year. But first, I want to wish everybody a happy new year, happy 2017, and your families as well. And 2017 is actually a pivotal year, in my opinion, again. But this is the year we've got to break out, okay? This is the year you got to break out, because there is a lot of uncertainty, you know, coming up. Wanted to, you know, we've all invested a lot of time, money, resources, whatever you want to call it. It has to pay back sometime. And I'm saying that we need to get that payback this year and with a little urgency, okay? So that's what this webinar is going to be. And of course, there's also going to be another one. And, you know, basically what I just said is your, you know, Option Tiger is being reinvented with a little, you know, like I said, a sense of urgency. It's not panic. It's not fear. But it's just a sense of urgency that we got to do it now. People who just joined Option Tiger in the last few months may not have heard from me live. And so, you know, just to have something different there, we are, of course, Option Tiger 2.0. And that means, you know, got to have a different picture there. But, you know, I've been an options trader for 10 years. And so I also have a, you know, a couple of eBooks, and I do mentoring as well on Udemy. Of course, I'm a best-selling educator in the finance and trading space. I have a bachelor's degree in engineering from India and an MBA from Columbia Business School, and as well as London. So now let's get going, because, you know, there is, like I said, there's a sense of urgency this year, and we've got to do something about it. Okay. You can't just simply sit back and let things happen, because that's not going to be healthy for you. I mean, okay, if you're not invested in the market at all, then that's fine. But if there is risk, there is also reward. Remember that. People only think like, oh, the other way around, but it's not. When there is risk, there is reward. Think of John Paulson, 2008, right? I think many people must know him. He made $4 billion from the housing crisis, okay? John Paulson. And so did many others. And so what we're saying is there is opportunity here. We have to be vigilant, and we have to be able to identify when those opportunities may come and what are the sort of indicators that something is going to happen along these lines. But other than that, nobody knows for a fact what's going to happen, because now we are talking about pretty much out of, you know, any one entity or country or, you know, market or whatever you want to call it. It's completely out of everybody's hands. And so let's take a look at what those are. All directions. There's talk of new world orders being, you know, birthed right now. There are uncertainty amongst, you know, in the leaders themselves. Superpower conflicts, trade wars, and recent elections in the US, UK, and Italy clearly show that, you know, people's sentiments are changing. Okay, there's something going on. We still don't have a finger on it, but there is something going on. Now, the games that the Federal Reserve play, and, you know, the artificial market levels and the artificial levels of stocks, they've been out of control for last few years. In fact, after the crisis. And today, I mean, they've always been very high, and today it's at peak. So, which means what? If you're already at your peak, you're borrowed up to your neck. And frankly, you know, the Federal Reserve, if you look at it, if the Federal Reserve was just an ordinary customer, they would be declared bankrupt. There's no question about it, okay? But debt to asset ratio of 35%, 40% maximum. If you go over the 50% threshold, people generally don't give you, extend you credit. I mean, that's the situation we are in. But the Fed, believe it or not, they have 98% debt and 2% assets, okay? So that's how bad the situation is. And that's been going on for a while. Artificial market levels, what do I mean? I mean, it's not that there is a conspiracy or anything, but by simply by keeping interest rates at zero, baby boomers and retirees, what are they going to do with their money if they're going to get 0%? So they're automatically, not forcibly, but they're automatically channeled into the stock market. And that's what has been, you know, going on. It's been, the stock market's been rising and it's just going out of control as far as the stock market is concerned. You know, they say 12 million jobs. And in, with all these financial numbers, you've got to understand, the numbers that you see on TV and on headlines is not the real numbers, okay? So just in America right now, we have, yes, Obama can claim he created 12 million jobs. And by the way, you know, none of this is political from my side, okay? I'm just looking at it from an economic, from a business perspective. So it's not a political statement at all. Obama can claim that he created 12 million jobs. Who did the Excel calculations and looked at various segments of the population? Where were the jobs created? Where were the jobs lost? If you look at that, we are basically sending $100,000 jobs away from the country and, you know, burger flippers and, you know, those kinds of jobs. It's very low value jobs. There's no real, beyond the basic skills, there's really nothing involved over there. So we are eroding value. So that's a problem. Second problem is, let's make no bones about it. We are indebted like crazy, okay? 20 trillion or not, by now it's probably 22. So all these factors are converging in some sense. You can feel it, you know, the tensions between Russia and us. Not just Russia and us. I mean, there's China, there's all these guys, North Korea, Iran. I mean, there's plenty of players around the world who now believe that they are strong and powerful to, you know, oppose any world power. I mean, you know, in a way that's good. But the problem is, some of these are very rogue states with rogue leaders. Okay, so if you look at it from that angle and you're wondering what's going to happen in 2017, you have your antennas are going berserk, basically. Okay, why? Why is it going berserk? It's coming up. Why? Because Jan 20th or whatever, Mr. Trump comes into the White House. But he is, let's face it, he's pretty unpredictable guy, right? I mean, and he can, you know, quick, whiff of things, you know, he can create anything, any kind of damage. So that is a big scare. And not just for the US, the rest of the world is even more scared of Mr. Trump. So, you know, that's the big thing coming up in January itself. So if you look at your normal indicators to see what's going on and, you know, how would you determine what is the overall general high level risk in the market, people generally go to the VIX. And I'm going to be, you know, there are some things I want to do today, which is show the real deal.